Hello, I'm Nathan Drendel, ProMedica's Total Wellness Dietician. Today we are continuing our healthy cooking series with the butternut squash soup. When the temperature outside is chilly, this is an excellent, quick, and healthy soup for the family. For the butternut squash soup recipe, you'll need 1 tablespoon of olive oil, 1 large onion, about 2 pounds of butternut squash, 1 large carrot, 3 sprigs of fresh rosemary, 4 cups of low-sodium chicken broth or vegetable broth, 3 bay leaves, and 1 cup skim milk powder. We're going to start the recipe with the olive oil. We'll put in our saute pan and add our diced onions. We'll let that cook for a little bit, roughly 3 to 4 minutes, and try not to caramelize or brown those onions. Now the olive oil, as you probably all have heard, is a very heart healthy oil to use. But when you cook with it, keep it in a lower temperature type of recipe. This would be a good idea, but deep frying or even sauteing something at a very high temperature, olive oil isn't the oil for choice. I'm going to start up my burner and put on low to medium heat and my tablespoon of olive oil and let that warm up just a bit before I add my onions. We're using a white onion for this recipe. Now white is one of the 5 colors of the vegetable and fruit family. White, red, green, orange, and blue/purple. The white onion is an excellent source of cancer preventers. So that's why we have that in this recipe. Dicing up the onions to get a nice fine little chop, because you don't want big chunks of onion when it's pureeing. Because we aren't gonna caramelize these onions, we're just gonna cook them thoroughly to break down some of the membrane on them. Now that the olive oil's warmed up, I'll add some of my onions. And I'll make sure those get all mixed around. And we'll let those sweat for about 3 to 4 minutes. Now that the onions are cooking, I'm gonna cut up the carrot. Again, seeing that this soup will be pureed, you don't have to mince it or make real small, but you wanna make sure you get enough carrot flavor in the soup. So you wanna give as much surface area as you can without being a tax on your body of cutting very small carrot pieces. 1 large carrot has a good source of beta carotene. Beta carotene is a form of vitamin A, but it cannot be toxic to the human body because our body naturally will get rid of too much of it. Also, we have the butternut squash. Again, great source of beta carotene. Also fiber, and in the American diet, we only get roughly about 10 grams of fiber a day. Men need roughly 35 to 40 grams of fiber a day, and women need roughly 25 grams. So this soup is an excellent source of fiber, beta carotene, and other vitamins and minerals. Now that our onions have sweated for a little bit, I'm gonna add the carrots and mix those in there to get them releasing some of their carrot flavor. Keeping a close eye on to make sure those onions don't caramelize, because you don't want the soup to be a sweet soup. And if you let the onions caramelize, you might get a sweet undertone in the soup, and that goes away from the earthy flavor that you're aiming for with this soup. I went to the store and I picked up about a 2 pound butternut squash, a little bit over because you have to compensate for taking the peel off and the tops and the bottoms. So I'm gonna cut that open. Be very careful because squashes are a dense vegetable. You'll have the seeds in the bottom. We'll get to that later. Okay, now that I cut it in half, I'm going to quickly try to peel it here. Now as I seed the acorn squash, I would keep the seeds. Just like pumpkins, you could wash them off, clean them, and then you can bake them in the oven with a little bit of salt or other herbs that you would like, and you could have a nice healthy snack there. Now just as the onions, you don't have to dice the squash too fine, but you want to make sure there's enough surface area that the squash will get a nice flavor release and get tenderized. Now that we have my 2 pounds of butternut squash sliced up, gently add that to the onion and carrot mixture. Now that it's in there, I'll gently toss it with the onions and carrots. Let that sit there for a little bit. Going to get my 3 sprigs of rosemary. I'll add those in just on top there. And now, as that's heating up, I'll add my low-sodium chicken stock. Again, if you want vegetarian route, you can get vegetable stock. Now, I made sure I got the low sodium because typically we as Americans consume way too much salt in our diets. This 33% reduced sodium chicken broth will cut down some of the salt without taking away any of the flavor. Before I cover this, I'll add my 3 bay leaves. I'm just going to make sure everything's immersed in the chicken stock without damaging the leaves or the rosemary sprigs, because we don't want little pieces of rosemary floating around. And then I'll simply cover and let it simmer for about 12 to 15 minutes or until the vegetables are tender. Now that our vegetables have been simmering for about 15 minutes, just remove the top and I'll take out the rosemary and the 3 bay leaves, and make sure you get all 3 bay leaves because you don't want an extra leaf floating around in there when you puree it. As you can see, the squash is nice and tender, so that'll make it easy to puree. And before I puree it, I'll add the 1 cup of non-fat dry milk powder. And again, I'll quick stir that in so we don't have powder flying all over when we puree. Before you blend, make sure you turn off the heat. And then if you do use a hand blender, make sure you put it in before you turn the blenders on. And just do it. Never have the motor running outside of the soup. And if you do, you'll be covered in soup. When you see that there's no chunks left, make sure you take your blender out and plug it. And then your soup is ready to be served. I dished up a bowl of our healthy butternut squash soup. And now the most important part, the taste test. Wonderful. You get the nuttiness from the butternut squash. You get the milk powder that provides a creaminess, and you have the rosemary that really stands out and provides an earthy flavor. Well, again, thank you for joining me for this healthy butternut squash soup recipe. My name is Nathan Drendel, ProMedica's Total Wellness Dietitian, where our mission is to improve your health and well-being.